In the American Southwest, a once robust mining town is looking to a growing arts community as a new economic driver. Stephanie Tsai reports on how Ajo, Arizona, is trying to cast off the image of a ghost town and become an arts destination. It's part of our American Creators series and ongoing arts and culture coverage canvas.
In the middle of the 10,000 miles of the Sonoran Desert lies a dusty town near the Arizona border with Mexico. A central plaza built in Spanish colonial revival style emerges like an oasis, a vestige of an era when Ajo had a successful copper mine. Today, it's reinventing itself through art.
A couple more things, we gotta be sure that we get that.
On an atypically cloudy Monday afternoon, visiting artist Christopher Lutter Gardella was busy putting up his latest work in the center of the plaza. The dove is made of reclaimed materials and incorporates written messages of peace from students across the border.
Inviting everybody in and celebrating our common humanity was really important at this time.
This was a bus schedule.
Artist Tom Kiefer moved to Ajo in 2001 from Los Angeles.
This was an early photograph I took.
His current work focuses on everyday items confiscated from migrants trying to cross the border.
That's when El Sueño Americano, the American dream, began. Those items were confiscated and thrown in the trash. It is my hope that I photograph them with reverence and deep regard and respect.
Like a lot of old mining towns in the West, Ajo could easily have fallen into obscurity were it not for an investment in the arts.
When artists and creatives come in a critical mass, really interesting things start to happen.
Aaron Cooper is the executive director of the International Sonoran Desert Alliance, which 15 years ago converted classrooms from the old Curly High School in the center of town into live-work units for artists.
So it didn't matter if you lived in Indian Village or Mexican Town or the predominantly Anglo town center, everyone went to school at the Curly School.
It was a symbol worth preserving, he says.
Turns out I really like it here.
Bobby Narcha grew up an hour away on the Tohono O'odham Nation and is one of the artists that resides in the Curly School.
It's not a big adjustment from the res, aside from, you know, a little more diverse audience out here.
The project was a spark for an economic and artistic revival. Public art now abounds in this town. This is Artist Alley. The community hopes attractions like this will make Ajo much more than a pit stop on the way to Mexico. There are signs it's working. Annual growth in tourism as measured at the visitor center quadrupled between 2015 to 2018. 100% of the plaza's storefronts are occupied.
A beautiful public square, murals, those kinds of things really help make people feel like they own the space.
Jason Schubach, who has examined how to harness the arts to spur economic growth, says investments in places like Ajo paid off in the years after the Great Recession. And he sees the same opportunity with the COVID pandemic.
Every single community, there are those artists. We call them culture bearers. They're the holders of our culture in those places. And we need to activate those people to help us find a way forward.
Besides attracting entrepreneurs, artists themselves have become business owners.
I started selling a friend's coffee from Tucson.
Annalise Cooper, who uses fibers and textiles for her woven paintings, started her own coffee roasting business 5 years ago. And she hopes her cafe, which recently relocated, becomes a community hub.
What do you want your business to mean to Ajo?
Well, I think it's a meeting ground, especially during this pandemic time. And it has continued to grow because the community enjoys what it is that I'm doing.
When I first came here, but there was literally no local food system to talk about.
Nina Sahovec has built up a local farmers market and farm-to-table cafe, utilizing indigenous agriculture. Since the pandemic, she and volunteers have been focused on distributing food to those in need.
We are working with the groups here in Ajo, offering up to 200 deliveries a week.
Tom Kiefer has witnessed the transformation of Ajo.
There's this vibrancy, this determination of trying to lift yourself up by your own bootstraps and make this work.
Keeping a rural town like Ajo from fading into history isn't easy or cheap. Its redevelopment was largely subsidized by government and foundation grants. But Cooper says these places are part of the nation's colorful tapestry.
If everybody moves to the urban centers and leaves the rest of America and the world out to sort of fall into disuse and disrepair, we lose a lot of stories, we lose a lot of opportunities for resiliency, we lose a lot of opportunities to have connection to land and landscape.
The hope now is not only that Ajo becomes self-sustaining, but that it becomes a model for the reinvention of small rural towns across America. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Stephanie Tsai in Ajo, Arizona.